Okay, so what we'll do now is we'll include within this in this package a data conversion. So we'll convert our string data, so the monthly spend data, which is in a string format, into a data format, so we can perform a transformation on it. So we'll pull the data conversion transformation through. We connect it up. And we then open it up. So it's the monthly spend information. So what we'll do is we'll convert it into currency. And so where are we? So we just need to find that currency. That should be fine now. And then we'll connect back up to the aggregate function. So we've got to customer ID. This is, make sure we pick the monthly spend column. We don't go back and pull on the string again. So here we go. We've got the full range of transformations here. So let's do a average. Let's do a monthly. Let's do a sum, and then okay, we'll perhaps rename them Av. Sum, and that's it. So that looks pretty good. Now we'll just make sure that this has actually worked. So what we'll do is connect it to another transformation, but we won't actually use that other transformation string attached to it, a data viewer, which will then allow us to see what the output looks like. See whether we do get those averages and sums coming through, which I'm pretty confident we will. And then now we just go to the little triangle to set the package off running. Okay. So here we go. We've got a 23 rows of data, so that means there's one row per customer. We've got average monthly spend, and we've got a sum of the monthly spend. So the data conversion and the aggregate function has worked. So pulled 69 columns rows through, converted it into currency, the monthly spend into a currency format, and then we ran an aggregate on it. We had three rows for each of the 23 customers, and then the output was aggregate data for 23 customers. What I do, I won't pipe this off into a destination location, say another Excel file or a SQL database. I've demonstrated how to do that in earlier demonstrations. So I'll leave that there. And tune in for other, if you want to see some other functionality within SQL Server, feel free to have a look at some of the other YouTube demos that I've done.